Yo, where is Giannis Antetokounmpo at? He has missed six games. Today he might miss his seventh, and it has us questioning what is going on with our bro. Hit that intro.
I can't do this on my own, 'cause you know things ain't always sweet when you out here in these streets. But my morpher when it morph, I made a fake.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to the fan club. Hope you guys are having an amazing day. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We have a pretty cool episode today. It's more of like fan theories, asking questions. This is speculation. And you know, the real facts are Giannis is missing. We haven't seen him in six games. The Bucks beat the Minnesota Timberwolves yesterday, spanked them, and today we play the Atlanta Hawks, who don't really have anybody available. They have like five guys out and two guys questionable. We're talking Trae Young and Gallinari. They're questionable, and basically the rest of their team is hurt. So we're probably not going to play Giannis today either, unless they're thinking he's ready to come back. Now, we have seen some workout videos and practice footage of him, and he's shooting, he's playing. They say that he has left knee soreness. Now, if you have seen Giannis Antetokounmpo's game, it is predicated on his knees, the way he jumps, the way he blocks, his explosion. If he's having knee troubles, that would hurt the Bucks, Giannis. It would hurt the franchise, and maybe the Bucks are just trying to take it easy on him. That is the first thing, the first assessment of the situation is, hey, if he's having knee soreness, let's take it easy. We have some other like all-star caliber players that can go out and play and win games as of yesterday. And you're not gonna win all of the big games versus the good teams without Giannis, but you are able to win some games against some bad teams and give Giannis a break. Okay? And this is most likely what Bud is trying to do. Now, we haven't seen Giannis miss a long stretch like this in a while. So we're just kind of, we have questions about it, and it's probably, like I just said, it's probably the right thing to do in the sense of last year he got hurt in the playoffs. And he played almost every game, even though his minutes weren't full. Maybe they understand they need to take it easy on this man's knees, so when we do get into the playoffs, the explosion is still there. Now, that brings me into our next point, is maybe this is something that is a concern. Giannis has been one of those players that has not been an injury-prone type of player. He has played a lot of minutes and a lot of games. Now, the last few years, I will say that his minutes have been somewhat limited. Now, obviously, he's an MVP, but a lot of people got a little upset that Bud wasn't playing him more during the big games in the regular season and in the postseason. They were capping him off a little bit around 30 minutes a game, and it was cool, but he's got to have some more run in those big moments at the end of the game to just keep being the dominant MVP player. If you want to ring, you got to stay out there, because in the playoffs, you're going to need to be out there and maybe only take a breather or two every game. So it's an interesting situation with Giannis. He has not shown us at all that he's really has anything wrong with him. This is more of, hey, what's going on? Where is he? I was just watching some practice footage. He was draining threes. He looks good. He's jumping. Like I said, though, if you're getting soreness in the knees, you're having trouble with your knees, take a break, Yanni. It's okay. We have some dogs on the team. Yes, we're gonna miss you. We're gonna miss your dominance and the way you impact us on defense and offense. But the Bucks have put themselves in a situation where they have other good players on the team. Now, we don't have Anthony Davis like the Lakers, or we don't have KD or James Harden or Kyrie in the Nets, but we do have Drew Holiday and Chris Middleton and some compliment guys that are really dope, like Bobby Portis has came into Giannis's role basically, and he's killing it. He's doing a great job. He is no Giannis, but man, he plugs right into Giannis's role, and usually we get that off the bench. So he's a nice player. He's one that we're going to appreciate for this 1 year that he's here. Because Bucks are running out of money. I think someone's going to throw some money at Portis in the future. And that's okay. I mean, I'm okay with having a brand or a franchise that does this and takes guys that, you know, have been struggling or haven't been the best and turns them into an ascending player, because you'll get more guys like that. And it means that you develop players. So I'm 100% for that. Bobby Portis, there's no way he's going to be here next year. Now, if he does, this would be amazing, like awesome. But it's okay. We can flip players like this. This is a good thing. This, like, you know, you're trying to get someone like that next year that is in the middle, and you're trying to pitch them. Hey, we just had Bobby Portis here. We think we can do the same thing to you. This is good. The Bucks are in a good situation. They're third in the East. They haven't done enough in my mind to put them at number one. But the Bucks have not been concerned about that number one seed this year, because they have been changing their defense, changing up how they run their offense together. And it's mostly the biggest change that I've seen is on the defensive end. And it's fun to watch this team. I think that they have some dogs that are kind of going to come alive in the playoffs, and they're a dark horse. And I know it's crazy, but they're one of those dark horse teams that I really see making the playoffs and tearing it up. It's only right. You know, if you keep going to the playoffs and losing, you're going to learn from your mistakes. You just got to keep going to the dance, keep going to the dance. The last few years were disgusting for Bucks fans. Last year we got upset by the Heat, and the year before we got to the Eastern Conference Finals. We're up 2-0 and lost 4-2. So it's been tough, but I think this team has done what they need to get them ahead, as long as Giannis is there. So I'm all about protecting this guy's knees. It doesn't seem to be a huge problem yet. We just kind of have to wait to see him come back. But I'm going to give bro the benefit of the doubt for now. I know a lot of people are like, oh, here becomes the beginning of the end. But we don't know yet. He did not have that crazy knee injury. He's still practicing. He's still working out. So we'll see. But what do you guys think about this? Is this not a big deal, nothing to worry about? Or is it something we should start to get scared about? Let me know in the comments. You guys know what to do. If you like this video, hit the like, hit the subscribe button, hit that notification bell. Check us out on all social media platforms, and make sure you check us out on buymeacoffee.com/thefanclub. You send us a coffee, a little bit goes a long way, and we really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much. We'll see you next time. Peace. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscription button, and also hit that notification bell to stay in the algorithm. Do you guys support the fan club? You want to help us make our next episode and keep this show running? Well, check out our brand new fan club t-shirts. These are on our Square site. Go check that out. Go check us out on all social media platforms. And thank you for rocking with us, guys.